In the future, we're going to have a lot of very precise statements about the derivative. But before we get there, I want us to have some intuition as to what's going on. Let's take a look at just the SIGN, the sign of the derivative. The thick green line is the plot of some random function, and the thin red line is its derivative. And note that when its derivative is positive, the function's increasing, and when the derivative's negative, the function's decreasing. We can try to explain what we're seeing here formally with a calculation on paper. So let's suppose that the derivative is positive over a whole range of values, and we also know something about how the derivative is related to the function's values. The function's output at x plus h is close to the function's output at x, plus how much the derivative tells us the output should change by, which is how much the input changed by, times the ratio of output change to input change. All right, now let's suppose that x plus h is a bit bigger than x. Well, what that's really saying is that h is positive, right? I shift the input to the right a little bit. Well, then h times f prime of x is going to be positive, because a positive number times a positive number is positive. And that means that f of x plus h times f prime of x will be bigger than f of x. I'm just adding something to both sides of this inequality. Now, f of x plus h times f prime of x, that's about f of x plus h. So although this argument isn't entirely precise yet, what it looks like it's saying is that the function's output at x plus h is bigger than the function's output at x. So if you plug in bigger inputs, you get bigger outputs. What about when the derivative is negative? We can play the same kind of game when the derivative is negative. Here we go. So again, x plus h is just a bit bigger than x. And in that case, h is positive. But I've got a positive number times a negative number. H times the derivative of f is negative. Now if I add f of x to both sides, I've got that f of x plus h times f prime of x is less than f of x. But this is approximately the new output value of the function at x plus h. So I've got that the function's output at x plus h is a little bit less than its output at f. So a bigger input is giving rise to a smaller output. Even this little bit of information, whether or not the derivative is positive or negative, says something about the function. And you can see the same thing in your own life. For instance, suppose you know that the derivative of your happiness with respect to coffee is positive. What does that really mean? Well, that means that you should be drinking more coffee, because an increase in coffee will lead to greater happiness. Of course, this is only true up to a point. After you've had a whole bunch of coffee, you might find that the derivative of your happiness with respect to coffee is zero. You should stop drinking coffee. This makes sense because the derivative depends upon x, right? It depends upon how much coffee you've had. Not very much coffee, the derivative might be positive, but after a certain point, you might find that the derivative vanishes. This seems like a silly example, coffee and happiness, but so many things in our world are changing, and those changing things affect other things. The question is that when one of those things changes, does the other thing move in the same direction, or do they move in opposite directions? And the sign, the SIGN of the derivative, records exactly that information.